So yesterday we discussed the vector inner product, the inner product between two vectors. Today let's look at the other form of vector multiplication, that is the cross product. Now unlike the inner product, which had a resultant scalar, the vector product or the cross product is going to have another vector as its solution. You might remember from physics where you had, say, R cross F, the position vector in that direction, the force vector in that direction, and then by the right-hand rule, the torque vector was pointing in that direction. So it is another vector. And no matter in which direction the two vectors point, they'll always form a plane, and the resultant vector will be orthogonal or perpendicular to those two. To do the cross product, I have to just talk about something which we haven't discussed before and is coming in a future lecture, and that's called the determinant. I just want to show you the determinant. If I have a vector, a 2x2 vector, and a matrix, I should say, 2x2 matrix, so row 1, column 1, row 1, column 2, row 2, column 1, row 2, column 2, the determinant of A written like that is just going to be, it's got to be a square matrix. And for 2x2, it's easy. As it gets 3x3, it gets a lot harder. We just do these diagonals. So it's going to be the product A11 times this one, A21, minus the product of these two. Don't get the order the wrong way around. A12 and A21. So if I were to have a matrix, and that matrix was 3, 2, 4, 1, the determinant of that matrix A is going to be 3, minus 8, that's negative 5. That way multiplication minus this way multiplication. So just remember that's the determinant, and we are going to discuss the determinant coming up. So let's have two vectors. I have my vector V, and let's make that 3 and 2. And I have my vector W, and my vector W is, say, 2 and 2. So if I were just to look at it, 1, 2, 3, x, and 1, 2, so that one's going to be 3, 2. That's not going to be my vector V, and 2, 2 is going to be my vector W. So right-hand rule, V, and then W, the resultant cross product is going to point straight at you. Look, if I do W times V, it points in that direction. These do not commute. The cross product of a vector does not commute. These two lie in the plane, so it's going to come out in this direction. There's one more thing that I just want to remind you of. We spoke about it, and that is the unit vectors. If I have three axes mutually perpendicular, let's make that I, let's make that X, let's make that Y, and let's make that Z. And if I let these little unit vectors go along these, and they are mutually orthogonal, we usually call this I hat, J hat, and K hat, or E sub X or E sub I and E sub J. There's various notations for this. Doesn't matter. It is these unit vectors. So this vector here, if I put another zero there and another zero there, it's still the same, exactly the same direction. 3 in the I hat direction, so 3 times this plus 2 times that, is still going to be this very same vector V here. And then 0 in the Z direction. So even if I had drawn it a different way so that Z comes out here towards you, it's still going to be 0 on this Z direction. And the way that we're going to do this vector multiplication as far as cross products are concerned, we're going to have an I hat, a J hat, and a K hat. And my first vector was 3 in the I hat direction, 2 in the J hat direction, 0 in the K hat direction. And it was going to be 2, 2, 0 for that one. Nice little 3x3 matrix. And I'm going to use this idea of determinants. I'm not going to get the determinant of this 3x3 matrix, but I'm going to use the determinant. One thing that I just want to remember is plus, minus, plus. And if it carried on to high dimension, plus, minus, plus, minus. You'll see now. Because I want to do something in the I hat direction, and that's always going to be plus. Then there's going to be minus something in the J hat direction, and then plus something in the K hat direction. And what I do to get this I hat direction is I'm going to close off the row that contains I and the column that contains I, and I'm left with this little 2x2 matrix, and I get its determinant. 0 minus 0 is 0. So for the J hat, I remember the minus that must be out there. It's that row and that column, and I'm left with 3 times 0 and 0 times 2, So 0 minus 0, 0. And then for the k, I close off the k, and I close off the column of the k, and I'm left with this little 2 by 2 matrix. So I have 6 minus 4 is 2. So V cross W is going to equal 0, 0, 2. There we go, in that order. And if I were to swap those two around, I'm not going to get the same, I'm not going to get the same solution. If it's W cross V, it's going to be 0, 0, minus 2. Just going to be into the board. So any kind of vector that you do, I mean, hopefully in your exams, you'll only get these multiplication of vectors that are in three dimensions. So as I say, if this was a 4 and that was a 1, that would be a 4, that would be a 1, and I would have some values there. But that's the easy way to do a vector cross product. Remember to put those extra zeros in if they just lie in two dimensions, but remember they're actually in three-dimensional space. There's going to be one coming out. The result at least. Remember that they do not commute, and remember this easy way of doing it if you have to do it with pencil and paper. Let's go to Mathematica and I'll show you how easy it is to do the cross product over there. So let's look at the cross product between two vectors. Let's use the proper function, which is cross. So I'm just going to do the cross product and I'm going to pass my two vectors. Let's keep it in two-dimensional space, 3, 2. But remember the solution is going to be in three directions. So I've got to put that extra zero there. And the other one is 2, 2, and I put my extra zero for the z-axis. And I close that, and indeed I see 0, 0, 2. So that is going to represent this orthogonal vector. Let's just do that in the other direction. Let's just make sure that we find at least one example where to show that it doesn't commute, and then we know the cross product of vectors do not commute. So it's 2, 2, 0 for the one, and the other one is 3, 2, 0. And there we go. And we see the solution, the negative 2. So same magnitude, but pointing in the opposite direction. So the vector cross product does not commute. Now, just to show you, there is another way to go about this. I'm just going to have 3, 2, 0. And then I can hold down the escape key and then write cross and escape key again. And I get this tiny little cross that is not the same as multiplication. So it's not the star 8. The shift 8 to get the star that is different. So 2, 2, 0, there we go, and I get the same solution, 0, 0, 2. So create your vectors, it's got to be in the same space, and you've got to add the extra 0 because whatever vector you create, it's going to be orthogonal to that, and you can go up to higher, much higher dimensional space as well. So very easy in Mathematica to get a vector cross product.